One, two. Hey guys, welcome back to another video. I'm back at it again in the cut with another helpful video for you guys. So in today's video, I'm going to be giving you the real tips and tricks to cashier like a pro. And although this is going to be helpful for all my Publix employees, if you're new here, I do a lot of Publix videos. You know, I help y'all get hired, help y'all get in the company, tell y'all what to do once you're in the company to ensure your success. But I wanted to switch it up a little bit today and also help people who work in different companies. So cashiering is kind of like one of those basic things. I mean, you could be at Walmart, at Target, at Walgreens, and if there's a cash register, they need a cashier and you need to know how to do these things. So this video is going to be helpful for that. I have cashiered in multiple departments and places before, so I know that for the most part things are pretty standard, and these tips and tricks will help you no matter what company you work at. So if you don't work at Publix, I still got you. And with that being said, if y'all could please subscribe to my channel, we're on a road to 5k, and make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. And what else do people do? Oh, comment below. I see what that's what the other YouTubers say, so I don't know, just comment below so I can see where y'all's thoughts are at, and if you guys have any questions and stuff like that, you know, I got you. We all friends and family up in this channel. So anyways, I'm just gonna go ahead and get right into it. Prior to this video, I actually recorded a different video about how to use the cash register, you know, the till, how to deal with the money, stuff like that. So if you haven't checked out that video, I suggest that you check it out. I'll try to link it up here at the top. If not, it will be at the end of this video. Or if you really, really want to check it out, make sure you click that Publix playlist, and it's going to be in one of those videos. So I suggest y'all watch that because it's been very, very helpful to many people, and that's what, you know, motivated me to do this video. Now, the first tip I could give y'all, okay, and when working retail and having to, you know, work on a cash register, even in restaurants or whatever, is to take your time. And I know everyone says this, and y'all are probably like, oh my gosh, Patricia, that is such a basic one. Everyone says the same BS and stuff like that. But the thing is, everyone always repeats the same thing, but it'd be y'all who don't take the advice, because I've been in your shoes before. Like, people be like, oh, Patricia, don't care if you go slow, just, you know, make sure you do it right. And I always hear that, and I'm like, bro, just like, you don't know what you're saying. But if you genuinely take that advice, it's going to enhance how you cashier. First of all, you're never going to be good at what you do if you don't practice it, okay? So eventually you're going to be able to move faster, but you got to learn how to do it right in the meantime. So make sure you go slow. And I feel like one of the tips that will help you go slow is to not care what other people think. So a lot of times people feel pressure, like the cashiers feel pressure, like, dang, I gotta swipe fast because so-and-so is in line, I got 10 customers, stuff like that. You're working for a big company, okay? Or regardless the size of the company, you're working for a company, okay? They can hire other employees. They have the money to do so. It's always these big managers who be making the most money, but you don't see them on the cash registers. If they feel, it's their store, number one. So if they feel like, you know, there's really, really long lines, they can also open up on a register. You know, don't take that pressure completely on yourself, because it's also going to cause you stress. And even if you do move slow, it might cause you to do things wrong, or, you know, mistake your money and stuff like that. And guess what? If you mistake your money and you get written up, the manager isn't going to come and save you. You know what I'm saying? So take your time. And in order to do that, like I said, don't be caring if these customers are staring you down like, you finna hurry up. Like, they can, first of all, wait their turn, okay? And if they have a problem, they can speak to a manager about it, and the manager can handle it, because you need to do, you know, you need to cashier the right way. So don't feel peer pressure. Don't feel anxious. Don't feel like you have to move fast. I know these customers be annoying sometimes. I know they be looking at you like, can't you go any faster? You do your pace, babes. You know what I'm saying? Especially if you're new, you need to really like get down to doing things correctly rather than just fast. All right. Now, next tip that I can give you guys is to be organized. So usually when you cashier on a register, that's going to be your register for that day. Okay. I know certain places assign people like specific registers, and that's usually the same register they be going on, but at least in Publix, in my store, and in the places I've cashiered at, you know, the registers switch up. So I might be on register 2 today, and tomorrow I'm going to be on register 7. So I'm never, you know, just tied down to one specific register. But for the most part, usually if Tuesday they assign me on register 2, I'm going to be there for all of Tuesday. They're not going to switch me different registers every single hour. So people be getting comfortable in their little space, and they be put in their water, they be put in their phone, they be put in their jackets all over the register. Now people are confusing their bags, people are taking your water, stuff like that. It is so important to be organized, because if you have a mess, I always say this, if you have a mess, your results are going to be a mess. And that goes for anything you do. You got a mess in your relationship's a mess. You got a mess in your room, your life's a mess. Like, I'm a firm believer of that, you know? So I would say keep your area organized, okay? If you bring a water, a snack, whatever it is that you bring, that's fine. Like, I know you be on these registers for a long time. Like, it's normal. You gonna get hungry. You gonna need some water. You gonna, you know, get cold, whatever it may be. But put it in the drawer. Put it on the side. Wipe down your register so that you're working in a clean space. Because the problem is, when you work in a dirty space, is that you don't want to touch certain things. You just feel like icky about the whole situation. You need to be comfortable. And one of the easiest ways to ease your way into being comfortable is to making sure your area is clean. So if they don't have cleaner under your register, which they're supposed to have, you can definitely request some, especially during this pandemic. Matter of fact, customers and managers will thank you for doing that. So make sure your area is clean and organized, because it's going to make you feel better and more confident when taking care of these customers and when having to move fast and when bringing them up. Another thing that I would suggest, and this ties with being organized, is to organize their groceries. So let me give you guys a realistic scenario of what happens. If I'm bringing up Susie, right? So Susie has 20 items. I scan them all, right? I put them in a bag, because you don't always have baggers. And now I'm waiting for her to pay. While you're waiting for her to pay, a quick tip, and like, this doesn't mean changing your focus or changing your attention from the customer. You can still be focused on the customer that's paying and stuff, because I'm not trying to tell you guys to shift your attention before the customer even leaves. You can still be focused, technically, let's say, on Susie and be fixing someone else's groceries. You know, it's just like multitasking. You get what I'm saying? So this is something you definitely need as a cashier, because if not, you know, you really might not enhance your cashiering skills as much as you want, you know, or as much as managers might need you to. Because I know certain companies, if you can't cashier too fast or stuff like that, they're not going to want you on a register, and there goes your job in the air. So we need to make sure we got this down packed, you know what I'm saying? So make sure that you guys are comfortable and learn how to multitask. And I can dedicate a separate video on that. It does take time. At first, multitasking is not easy, and that's in anything, you know, just like in general. Multitasking isn't for everyone. It's a skill that gets developed over time. Now, give me 1 second. Sorry, y'all, my dogs were barking. And what I was trying to explain to you guys is that while you're taking care of the customer, Susie, right, while she is paying, sometimes they got to be looking in their purse and they're fidgeting with their stuff, looking for their card, you know, trying to figure out how they're going to pay or whatever, and they're paying. And sometimes they're on the phone, sometimes they're not really acknowledging you. While they do that, you want to start organizing the person behind Susie. So now here comes Natalie. You need to start organizing Natalie's groceries. So some customers will do this for you just because it makes it easier for them to bag it, or, you know, for the baggers to bag and stuff like that. But not all customers do this, and this is a big one. I like to, you know, group things that are hot or group things that are cold, group produce products, which are products that you have to weigh on the scale in the register. I like to group everything together. So while I'm waiting for Susie to figure out how she's going to pay, while I'm waiting for her card payment to go through, while I'm just waiting for her to leave basically the register so I can take care of the next guest, I am going to be organizing the next guest groceries in the meantime. And this doesn't mean I'm shifting my focus from Susie. I'm going to have asked her everything I need to. You know, when you do retail, you got to be like, is there anything else I can help you with? Have a wonderful day. Da-da-da. You got to get her receipt and stuff like that. I'm still going to be doing that, but at the same token, I could be talking to her and over here fixing groceries. You know what I'm saying? If you know how to multitask. And that's a big one, because then when you scan, First of all, everything's going to be easier because you know that you're scanning the boxes. You know that you're scanning the items that you have to put on a scale. You know what it is that you're scanning. You know how to bag, which means you're going to make your line move quicker. Scanning, this is a big one, guys. Scanning is not that hard, okay? Everyone thinks it's so freaking hard. It's not hard. Scanning is not hard. What makes it hard is all the extra things that you do. You know what I'm saying? Like, the bagging is one of the biggest ones that also, it's not hard, but it's time consuming because after you scan 50 products, now you gotta bag them. So another tip I can tell you guys, if you don't have a bagger, how to do this is that as you scan, bag stuff. Don't wait to scan 30 items and then figure out how you're going to bag it, because at that point the bread is in the bottom, the eggs are in the top, and this and that. And I'm going to do a video on how to bag things because this is such a common question that I get, like, how do you bag this? It's pretty standard knowledge, but I know to some people it's not obvious, because it might only be obvious to you if you've worked retail, and not all my subscribers have, which is understandable. For the most part, the way these companies want you to bag stuff, and these customers as well, is the hot with the hot, the cold with the cold, you know, fruits in its separate bag, eggs is in its separate bag, stuff like that. And now I'm going to show you guys physical examples, because I'm such like a, I'm a personal like learner when I see things. Like, what is that kind of learner called? You ever did those surveys in high school where you were like, oh, I'm a visual learner. Okay, that's what I am. I'm a visual learner. So I can sit here and listen to you, but I really got to see. Also, so I'm gonna drop videos on that, like how to physically bag it, but just for some prior knowledge, hot with the hot, the cold with the cold, boxes, you know, if you get boxes of biscottis, boxes of cookies, put the boxes in the same bag. If you get chips like Doritos and Lay's, they go in the same bag. And for the most part, you can put quite a few things in these bags. You don't have to be putting like one thing per bag. Matter of fact, the companies don't even want you to put one thing per bag, because then you waste bags, and these customers don't want to be having a million bags either. So it's a pretty standard system, and I'll explain more in depth at another point. But you definitely want to be bagging these groceries as you scan, okay? Don't wait till everything stacks up and now things are falling off your register, because you don't even have that much register space for you to bag. Bag as you go, okay? And it's going to be easier to scan and bag if everything on the register is kind of like grouped together. And I know you can't reach towards the far end, but you know the things up there in the front of the register, try to organize. If you see 2-3 boxes, try to get them all together. Try to get the barcodes facing up so that you can just scan through and it can just be like beep, 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 beep. Like, you don't have to be trying to figure out where the barcode is at. And these little tips is going to make your line go quick. So trust me when I tell y'all, these are important tips. And I've personally done them, and I've always ran through a quick line. You know what I'm saying? I never have a lot of people waiting up in my line. My managers have always been happy with the way I cashier. So make sure you guys do this. Another tip, which I don't always necessarily follow, because sometimes, you know, these customers be giving you great conversation, but always remember that you're there for a job, and sometimes you gotta cut conversation, because if not, your line is gonna get gigantic. So it's not rude to say, oh my gosh, it was so good to see you. All right, well, I gotta go. I'll see you soon. You know, thanks for shopping with us or whatever. That's not rude, because these customers will sit there because they're only in the grocery store for maximum, maybe like an hour. They're in your specific, like line, in your grocery line or whatever, for what, maybe like 10 minutes at most. So they're ready to talk. A lot of these customers get out work at 6. You're the first person they see. They had a hard day. They want to let go of their problems, and this is not therapy session. And I've been there, y'all. I've been there. Like, some of these customers be crying to me, and I'm just like, how do I tell this person that I gotta go? But if you don't hear it from me, if you don't take this advice from me, you're going to hear it from your manager. Because I've heard it from my managers. And I'm always like, I'm always a sweet one who just doesn't want these customers to feel, you know, like no one cares. So I'm always the one like listening. But then, you know, you might have people in your line waiting. So you don't want that. So, I mean, I've even gotten to the point sometimes. I'm just telling y'all what I personally do at this point. So, you know, do with this information as you will. I'm telling you guys what you should do, but sometimes this is what I do. If the customer is really telling me something that they really, really want to tell me, because you end up building relationships with these customers like one-on-one, and they be wanting to tell you about their kids and their husband's ex-wives and like just everything. Sometimes I'll take the next customer and I'll be like, hi, how you doing? And I'm ringing them up and I'm still listening to what she's telling me about her ex who cheated on her. You multitask. That's all I can tell you. It's just such a big one. You multitask. It's also a good thing when you're on a register. And I'm sorry because I feel like I'm making this video pretty long. And I'm going to divide this video into multiple parts. So part two will be dropping soon. But my last tip for y'all before I finish this video is that it's good for you to recognize some of the deals that go on. Because this is going to make you a better cashier and customers are going to like you. Remember, the goal... Well, I don't know what y'all's goals is, but if you're anything like me, the goal isn't to stay as a cashier, it's to move up. And the only way to move up from a cashier, because at that point you are going to need, you know, to be good at what you do. Sometimes, you know, we don't have the best baggers, but we'll train them to be cashiers and it is what it is. But if you want to go from cashier to another position, you got to be good at what you do. If not, they will not promote you, because that's kind of like the fine line between staying as a cashier forever or like moving up to management and stuff like that. So if you want any type of like promotion or to move up and you know, do better in the company, you need to be good at what you do and you need these customers to like you, especially if you're working retail. So a quick and easy way for that is to know your deals. So that way when you're scanning someone's eggs or someone's bread, and I know you're not gonna know all the deals that happen in the store, but it's like kind of like the most popular ones. I mean, everyone usually buys like the same things. I know there's different items in everyone's carts, but everyone's buying, you know, the milk and the eggs and da, da, da. So a very important and a great tip is when you see someone buying eggs and you're like, oh, did you know that the Publix brand eggs are buy one get one free? Or maybe they might be buying like Little Bites and you recognize that the Little Bites were buy one get one free, and you can let them know like, hey, did you know that this one is buy one get one free? So you can go grab, you know, another box of Little Bites at no charge. And that makes the customer be like, really? Oh, thank you. Because, you know, some of these companies be, you know, raising their prices now, especially in the pandemic and stuff like that. So like, to these customers, like, wow, something free, like they weren't expecting it. So some customers, very few though, they genuinely just don't want the free item, but some of them just don't be reading and they appreciate when you let them know. And at that point, the customer likes you. At that point, you're getting recognition. If the customer does go and say something about you, you know, those are brownie points to moving up. So it's really like a whole process. And I know y'all got this. And if you have any other questions, and you know, can't wait for part two to drop, go ahead and let me know so I can also address those questions in part two and three. And like I said, stay in tune for that other video of more tips and tricks on the register, because like I said, I understand it can be confusing. So I'm here to help y'all. And with that being said, I'm just gonna go ahead and conclude this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye.